Hello everybody, welcome to the channel World of Self Learning. I am Mahesh here. Today in this practical, we are going to see Kirchhoff's voltage law. Yes, KVL, we are going to see KVL practically. So our agenda will be, so we will first see the simulation on the software and then directly go to the practical workbench. So let's start with the simulation. You can now see a simulation software. I am using a multi-sim software, okay. So I have built a small circuit here which is having a 5 volt battery, then two resistors connected in a series fashion, R1 of both of 1 kilo ohms. What our KVL states theoretically? KVL states that algebraic sum of voltage drop across elements in the circuit will be zero. Means what? So here, in short, if we talk in our circuit, the KVL will state that voltage provided by the power supply should be equal to sum of the voltages of these two resistors. So we will do some theoretical calculations first. You can see I have done them on the right side of the screen. We will see them first before measuring anything. So you can see the equivalent resistors, both are connected in series. So equivalent resistance will be R1 plus R2. So it will be 2 kilo ohms. Now we will find a total current in the circuit, which will be equals to voltage divided by equivalent resistance. It will be 5 divided by 2k. So it will be 2.5 milliamps. So current flowing through the circuit will be 2.5 milliamps. Now we will find voltage across each resistor, which will be V is equals to IR, our common ohms law. So current flowing through R1 is 2.5 and the value of resistance R1 is 1 kilo ohm. So we will get a 2.5 volts across it. Similarly, for R2, the current will be same and also the resistance value is same. For simplicity, we have chosen same values. So we'll get the same voltage, 2.5 volts. So what our KVL states, the voltage V should be equals to V1 plus V2. Let's verify that with our simulation. Now you can see, I have a multimeter here. You can see it's a multimeter. So we'll measure the voltage across R1 as well as R2. If you don't know how to measure the voltage and currents in the circuit, I recommend you to watch the video showing in the I button. There we have taken a separate practical for simply how to measure the current and voltages in the circuit. So see here in the circuit now. Now we'll measure the voltage across V1. So I will put the leads. For measuring the voltage, we have to put the multimeter in parallel with the component. So here we have put the multimeter in parallel. We will run the simulation and we'll see the results. Okay, we got the result. Across R1, we are getting 2.5 volts. Similarly, we will measure for R2. We'll delete this wire. Now we'll connect it across R2. After doing this practical, you also get to know how to use the multisim. I have connected a multimeter across to the resistor R2. Now we'll run the simulation and see what result we got. You can see we are getting 2.5 volts again across R2 because we have chosen the similar values of resistance. So we are getting the same value, 2.5 volts. So we got the value across R1 as 2.5 volts and value across R2 as 2.5 volts. So what is our total voltage across both the resistors? It will be 5 volts. And what we are getting from a power supply? It's 5 volts. So this equation is verified. So we can say our KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, is verified. So we have done with simulation. Now let's go to the practical workbench, build this circuit, measure the values and see practically how they work. So let's go to the practical workbench.
Hello friends, welcome to the workbench. You can see on a workbench we have made a setup of two resistors in series. As we build the circuit on a simulation, same circuit we have built it here, and we are going to see the KVL law practically. Okay, you can see on a breadboard we have bring the power supply of 5 volts. we have two resistor each of 1 kilo ohms connected in series. You can see it is in series circuit and having a multimeter set to the voltage mode. So let's start with the practical. What the key will state that algebraic sum of voltage drop across each elements in the circuit leads to zero. So I will show what power supply is coming. You can see a reading on a multimeter. It's 5 volts, accurate 5 volts. So the incoming power supply is 5 volts. So the voltage drop across the resistors should be what? 2.5 volts, as we see that in the simulation, because both the resistors are of same value. So let's verify it practically. If you don't know how to measure the voltage and currents, then see our video which is showing in the I button. There we have done a separate practical on a measurement of current and voltages. So now here we will measure a voltage across this resistor. You can see I have to put the multimeter in parallel with the resistor, and you can see the voltage reading is 2.5 volts. Okay, so we got our first reading. Let's verify for a second resistor. You can see it's again 2.49, very very close to it. Means make an approximation, if we go down by scale we will get a 2.45 as well. So we have verified that the incoming supply is 5 volts and the voltage drop in the circuit is 2.5 volts from this resistor and also 2.5 from this resistor, leads the summation to 0. So we have verified a Kirchhoff's voltage draw practically here. So we have done with our practical.
That's all for today's practical. We have learned practically the KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, how to determine the values and verify them. Okay, one announcement here. We have created a practical crash course electronics on our channel World of Self Learning. I request all of you to visit the playlist section. You will find many more such interesting practical videos there. So if you want to visit the course right now, click on the video showing on the right hand side. You will go directly to the course. We will meet a day after tomorrow with a new video, with a new concept, with a new practical. So goodbye.